Hey guys, so those of you that have been following distrowatch.com will probably know that the second alpha images of the Ubuntu distributions are now out. And there isn't usually too much to show in these images. It's usually, you know, there is some indication as to which direction the distribution might be going in. But when it comes to replicating a finished product, the alpha images are a little bit far off for most people's tastes. However, there is a new addition into the images, and that's Ubuntu Budgie. It was very recently made an official Ubuntu distribution, previously of course known as Budgie Remix, and I think it's still using the same website URL. I've got it up here. So I'm not going to talk too much about this distribution because it's very similar to the distribution Ubuntu Budgie Remix that I reviewed about four months ago when it was last out. And it looks like it's going to be sort of it looks like it's going to display the continuity of the Arc theme and the Arc design, which looks, if you ask me, absolutely lovely. I was wondering if they were going to go with like the human design to sort of make it look a bit more Ubuntu-esque, and it may very well develop a theme that's more fitting in with the Ubuntu family as time goes on. But it looks like they're going to stick with the Arch. That looks really, really nice. Everything looks like it integrates really well. And it seems like, for the most part, it's got all the good applets and stuff like that. But I don't see too many features around here that are worth talking about, except this. I want to talk a little bit about this, because I feel that this is a really good step forward for Ubuntu Budgie. And I like seeing that more and more distributions now are adopting good like welcome screens, because this is a first impression. Now, things like these welcome screens, they mean very little to sort of intermediate Linux users. We already know roughly where to look for what we're looking for and all this kind of stuff. But if you're new to a distribution or not a power user or anything like that, this intro screen is actually quite useful, quite good. And I mean, to be fair, if you're moving from one Linux distribution to this one, it might be good to have a look at what kind of things you can expect. So it gives you links into the community stuff. This looks very familiar to the Ubuntu Mate welcome screen. And I mean, if you know, it is open source, so if they have used that, then more power to them. I mean, that, you know, that is Ubuntu Mate have basically led the way with great welcome screens, and it's nice to see other distributions catching up as well. So one of the things I do like about this is it gives you a pretty good getting started guide, and it tells you updating your system, and it gives you the options there. You can install the restricted extras if you didn't do so on install. What else have we got? Optional tasks, drivers, performance tune. Now this is interesting. So I've disabled animations and remote display for running it in a virtual machine. And recommendations. So this is, they don't have a full software boutique like the Ubuntu Mate distributions do, but it does have some software recommendations. So you know, you can install the screenshot applet there. There is a way to display the windows very similar to GNOME 3, so that might be quite intriguing. And Steam, because Steam isn't available in the Ubuntu repositories normally. It is in the Ubuntu Mate software boutique, but it's not in as part of the Ubuntu repositories, so it gives you a way of installing it there, which is quite nice. And you can install Snap as well. Actually, that's already installed, it says down there. So it gives you a nice few recommendations. I don't know necessarily if I would have stuck Flatpak right at the top there, because I think a lot of people who might be sifting through the welcome screen might not have an earthly idea what Flatpak is or how, you know, its importance or relevance. But it's all fine, really. So you got getting started, chat room. So all of this stuff is really quite good. And features as well, tells you what you can do. So it gives you a starting point. It gives you a launch, and it tells you a little bit more. The default settings as well. This is quite good. It allows you to switch out your theme, and it allows you to reset the panels. So that is good. I don't know necessarily it's up there with the Ubuntu Mate software boutique. I mean, obviously, like, there's tons of work's gone into that, but this is pretty good. This is, I like this as a growing trend among sort of Linux distributions designed to have a degree of mass appeal. Is good welcome screens and good documentation. That's just not overwhelming. There's just not a manual in your face. It's like, here's where you can go for help. Here's some of the things that will help you get started. Here's how to install new software. Here's our social media links. You know, that's kind of basically it. And then maybe one or two specific preferential features. For the Software Center, it uses the GNOME Software Center, which is generally the Software Center used by most other Ubuntu distributions as well. It's pretty good as far as distributions go. It comes with... it doesn't come with Steam, and it doesn't come with Open Broadcaster software, so you still have to go out and get the devs for them. But it comes with the standard, what we've come to expect. So there's not any massive surprises in terms of what software is available. What's going to be available for Ubuntu is most likely what's going to be available here. So I really just wanted to share this welcome screen, this main menu. There is also another thing that I think is actually quite interesting. You may have noticed, of course, that the Chromium web browser is the one installed by default, whereas most other Ubuntu distributions use Firefox. However, you can very easily, in the Getting Started tab, select between four browsers: Chromium, Firefox, Google Chrome, and Vivaldi. And I think those are good four choices as well. I know some of you might say, well, what about, say, Cupzilla or Epiphany or Midori? But those, I suppose, I would say they're specialist browsers. They're not like, you know, they don't have the multimedia support that a lot of people might require, and they might not necessarily know how to go about navigating that particular situation. So that's really looking promising. And this is just a beautiful desktop environment. It looks a little staggery because I'm running it in a virtual machine, and that's also why my mouse looks a little bit funky. But yeah, overall, got to say, it's looking like it's going to be just an extension of Budgie Remix. But Budgie Remix was a fantastically good distribution. That sort of setting its praises rather highly. I mean, it is Ubuntu with Budgie on top. But it's done well, and I like it. And I look forward to seeing it once it's come out. But I've mostly done this video just to show the welcome screen, because it is a good old welcome screen there. And I like seeing it as a rising trend. So that's about it from me today. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, I've been Chris Ware, and you've been awesome. Take care now.